I wanted to start back in 2001 when the Ministry for the Environment and NGOs signed a common declaration of cooperation on issues under the Aarhus Convention, basically. And the parties were agreed that NGOs play an important role for democracy. And I think that's the essence of the Aarhus Convention. It is to strengthen and improve democracy. The ministry also committed to some funding of NGOs, and there was a strong reference to the Aarhus Convention, and the ministry also committed to ratification by Iceland, but it took another 10 years. And I refer you to our shadow report from April. It was written by help of an attorney, a friendly attorney, which took it on her to write it. Iceland signed the Aarhus Convention on site in 1998, but it did not ratify until 2011. Ratification became possible after the creation of an environmental board of appeals, which enabled review of decisions on permits and compliance with the convention's provisions regarding access to justice. However, Icelandic NGOs, since the ratification, cannot appeal to courts of law demanding a review of decision on permits and compliance with provision of the Aarhus Convention. We basically, when Iceland ratified, we were, we refer to this Environmental Board of Appeals, which is a lot weaker than a court of law. And in cases where this Environmental Board of Appeals has ruled in our favor, at least one case, the government has swiftly adopted new laws in order to nullify that decision by the board. The delay in ratification was said to be lack of national legislation on access to justice. In fact, there was a lack of political will. This independent commission was established, but it was basically in order to, or more or less, to keep us out of the courts. Therefore, access to justice in line with the Aarhus Convention is limited. Also, the judiciary and legislative branches of the government have failed. And twice the government has pushed legislation to parliament in order to nullify rulings by this commission. It has been criticized by professors at law at the Icelandic University for not living up to the Aarhus Convention commitments. Since 2011, no court case by NGOs has been accepted in Iceland. Actio Popularis, which is one of the main provisions of the convention, is not recognized in Iceland. NGOs still have no legal standing. NGOs are not granted free legal aid. They may end up paying thousands of euros for their court cases. And it has happened. Access to justice involves a financial risk which no NGO can take, except maybe one time. Access to information is guaranteed in law, but industry gets special treatment. And the industry, in particular energy, construction, and fisheries, perceive access to justice as granting NGOs the right to launch endless series of court cases. They have been very much opposed to granting this right to NGOs, and this explains why it took Iceland so long to ratify. And these interests are supported by conservative reactionary political parties. The left-green movement, once the champion of the Aarhus Convention, does not mention the convention in the policy today. And this is a green party, and this is the party of the prime minister. And it's said, they only say, in their policy to strengthen the legal status of environmental NGOs. They give no context. But I think Iceland is part of the international community, European Union, European Court of Human Rights, international conventions, the Nordic Council, and so on and so forth. And finally, a legal reform in Iceland is urgent, and it will happen thanks to us, even though we are on the periphery of Europe, so high up in the north, we are part of the outside world like you are, and I think incrementally we will get this right, access to justice, as society changes. It will happen, but I don't know when. Thank you.